Today I'm going to show you how to use Canva Magic Write to create 15 clues for a crossword puzzle, create a nonfiction text, and then we're going to put it into a crossword puzzle app using a third-party app within Canva. Okay, so to get started, we're going to open our Canva account and we are going to go to Doc. If that not on your dashboard, you would do create a design and you would go and find Doc here. Magic Write is Canva's AI writing guide. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be very specific about my prompt. This was something I tested out a bunch of times to see what exactly was the right prompt, how to properly put this together and things like that. So follow along as I write my prompt, because there's a specific order in which I need to ask AI to do this. So my prompt is, create me a 15 question crossword puzzle on a fourth grade level about Martin Luther King Jr. Put the clue and the answer on the same line, separated, this is important, by a comma, with the answer first in all caps, again, very important, and clue second. After the crossword puzzle, create a non-fiction text about MLK Jr. that includes all the answers so students can use it to solve the crossword puzzle. Okay, like it, I'm gonna click generate. Something that Docs does is it kind of jazzes up whatever you're putting in here. And I'm going to tell you in a few minutes why we don't keep it in Docs. But as you can see, AI is working. It's creating a text for me for the students to read. One of the things I can do once I read through and I make sure that the text is accurate, that I make sure it's correct, I will then say this, but if I wanted to make it longer or shorter, okay, if I wanted to make it more on my kids' level, for the purposes of this video, I'm going to say that it's fine. So I'm going to insert it. Now, we're not keeping it in Docs because you can't, this is like a Word document. So it's like Microsoft Word or Google Docs. If I was to put pictures or things like that, I'd have to put them in the text. I'd have to like wrap it. I'd have to, so they're not movable. So you're going to see when we do the crossword puzzle, like you're going to need to resize it, move it. You're going to be able to have to put the words and the clues underneath it. So you're going to need to have that flexibility to do that. The thing I'm going to do here is I am going to get rid of the numbers because we don't want anything next to us. So get rid of the check marks. There we go. So I'm going to copy this. Now I'm going to open a flyer. I'm going to do flyer portrait 8.5 by 11 and click on that. The first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to my apps tab and I'm going to look for activities maker. And it's right here. These are all some of the other third-party apps that are included here. I was really excited when I found this one. So you can do word searches if you want, but we're going to do a crossword. I'm doing a custom word list. So I had AI help me with finding the words in my clues. So I'm going to get rid of this. But as you can see here, it's capitalized. That's really important because that's how it has to be on here. The other thing I need to do, I need to remove any of the blank spaces. So like any of the dash marks, I need to remove those. Okay. I'm going to move this up to 15. This should be good. I'm going to click generate. Okay. So one of the things, it gives you the clues, it gives you an answer key, and it gives you the crossword. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do make another page here. I didn't have to duplicate. I could have just added a page. And I'm going to move right now the answer key to the middle page here. I can make it bigger so I can see it. So this is so like you have an answer key. It's always nice to have one of those. Okay. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put the down questions over here. It's nice because what it does is it puts these in a text box for you. So that's really helpful. And you can make these bigger. So I might put them on like a size 11 font, play with my text boxes a little bit here. Move it over. Can make these. What size font is this? 11.9. We'll make this one 11. We'll see what we do if I do 11.5. Okay, so I made it a little bigger. I want all my words, sentences on one line. There we go. Okay. Now, here's my crossword puzzle. I'm going to make this bigger too, so the students have more room to put it in. Okay. So now, one of the things that I can do is I can jazz it up. I can add a title to it if I want to. And I can put that over here in a text box. So I'm going to go back to my text. I'm going to do all about MLK Jr. And I'm going to put that over here. One of the other things you can do is I can go to elements and I can look for pictures of Martin Luther King. Always nice to associate a picture with a person. And then I can add other graphics if I want to. Could put this on here if I would like, down here. Here he is giving a speech. I could put that in there if I wanted to, but you can jazz it up a little bit any way you want to. Now, the other thing that we did was we had a question. We had a nonfiction text. So I am going to go back here and I'm going to copy this. Okay, do copy. And I'm going to add a text box. Oh, copied the wrong thing. So I'm going to do that again. I'm going to add a text box. And here we go. I'm going to make it a little smaller. Okay, I'm going to change my page a little bit here. And I'll put extra, I'm going to change my layout. Again, some of this is just for me, for style points, I guess you could say, or how I want my students to be able to read the document. So I can make it bigger like this for them. They can see a little bit better. And then I'll add my heading and I'll do all about MLK. And I'll put that up here. Okay. So there we have it. We have all about MLK crossword puzzle. We have the answer key. We put the questions down here. And then lastly, we have our nonfiction text. So the students, you would print this out. The students would read through this, try to find the answers to their crossword puzzle. One of the ways you can share it with them, I'm going to click on share over here. You can get a link to Google Classroom. If this is linked to your MLS or LMS, you can click on there, or you can create an assignment. This will allow you to create. You could create a Canva assignment, Google Classroom, and click on your learning management system. If I click on Google Classroom, I can share, and I could pick new design for each student, instructions only, or they could work actually on this design that It's up to me as the teacher. If this is something I prefer to them to do, like in a center time, something like that, I can click on share. Then I can click download. And the best one would be PDF print. And I can click on that. All three pages I can download, and then I can print it out as I would like. Okay. You can jazz this up a little bit more. That's why I wanted to show you some of the features. You could add a background to this page if you wanted to, but that was a quick and easy way to show you how to use Canva Magic Write to help you create a crossword puzzle with your students and include a nonfiction text. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. My email is volskai, volskaim@cliu.org. Thank you.